So I started dancing when I was about 6 years old. You know, one of those kids you would see being dragged into a ballet class ready to be tortured? Being ballerina structured my body and gave me a certain discipline. The liveliness of the dance made me balanced and moderate in life. When I had enough of myriad periods and constant dizziness from spins, I turned to the opposite style, hip-hop. Now, my body was moving into the beat. As my style of dancing changed, I myself changed in the way I expressed my emotions. I didn't need anything but a move to show what I felt. I didn't need words, written or spoken, to talk, because my body was doing it for me. Yet, we live in a world where words are being prioritized over movements, where communication is considered successful if we talk something through. The idea of verbal communication is to make sure that both sides understand the information, and the only way of doing it is if both sides follow a set of rules, such as a language, to convey a message. But what happens if we don't understand what the other person is saying? Well, we will rephrase the sentence, clarify what we mean, add relevant details, bring in examples, tell that story we read on Facebook, desperately tell, add more details and words, because we're compelled to label things. We've even come up with an excuse. I can't find the right word. Well, who said there was the right word? What defines the right word? Is there a dictionary titled "The Right Words to Say"? And even if there was, well, when did we all agree on those words? Personally, I don't remember agreeing on saying "well," "like," or any other possible words. It makes us nervous when we're confronted with something indefinite, something that doesn't have a predetermined meaning to it. All of a sudden, we frown, bite our lips, mumble some meaningless words, make weird sounds like that are supposed to give us a hint as to what to say next. Sometimes I feel like the evolution of human existence has turned us into Google translators of emotions. If you think about a language, its dialects spread all over the country, assimilating with communities, cultures, history in different areas. People there get closer to their descent for the sake of communication. But there are some things you can't express through words. Some feelings that lose their magnetism when said out loud. Yet, we still want to share them, add meaning to them, without spoiling them with oversimplified labels. So, just as a dance has numerous styles to convey a performer's message, language has numerous dialects. Those styles take the body language to an extreme and wipe any borders between feelings and their expressions. When we dance, we dissolve in the movements. We become wild because at that exact moment, we're in sync with our inner selves. You may argue that not everyone can dance, just as not everyone can sing, but dance itself isn't limited to fleshed out choreography, perfect spins and stances. It goes deep into our nature of existence, into our subconscious intention to move with an impulse. As a young ballerina in the dance studio and a modern dancer now, I could never remember the process of dancing once the music would fill in the space. Every beat would go into another motion. I let my body move with the beat and I wasn't in control of it anymore. I myself would follow the continuum of movements. As I was writing down this talk, I realized it completely proves my point. I've talked about dancing as a way to convey more complex feelings and have done it through words. Isn't it upsetting that I had to write about dancing and then talk about it just to make a clear point and express my feelings? To make your life easier so that you can understand me? Well, I would be a coward if I didn't change it now.
I could stay like this. voice forever following you. Just don't get too far.